Well, it smells like death. And really, that's the point. I mean, why else would this thing be called the corpse flower? Well, today it's finally blooming, and Sheldon Ingram is with the people ready to hold their noses.
It's called one of the most unique flowers on the planet. Its blooming cycle is so brief and so rare, the flower is approached with reverence. This is the Amorphophallus titanum, also known as the corpse flower.
I've heard about this plant about 10 years ago on TV. I think there was one in New York, and I just always wanted to see it.
The size of it and the fact that it's one of the heaviest flowers on the planet.
The fact that it blooms so infrequently. And we have it here in Pittsburgh, and I think it's fabulous.
Visitors at the Phipps Conservatory trained their cameras on Romeo, the resident corpse flower. They're capturing a short-lived bloom lasting only 24 to 48 hours. It started Tuesday at 5 p.m.
This is the holy grail of the plant kingdom, to get one of these things to bloom. If you're at all interested in plants, even the littlest bit, this is a big deal.
Here's a picture of the corm, the base that gives the flower all of its energy before it grows. Once it reaches that rare full bloom, the spadix sprouts out. That's the thick stem sticking up. After 48 hours, it goes through degeneration and comes back as the green leafy stage, like these two here. During the leafy stage, it can weigh as much as 200 pounds. After that, it blooms again, but it takes 6 to 10 years. So Romeo isn't expected to provide another moment like this until somewhere between 2019 and 2023. Sheldon Ingram, Channel 4 Action News.
And because of that, the conservatory is going to be open through 2 o'clock tonight, 2 a.m., we should say, tomorrow morning. If you want to see the corpse flower, and they're also having a screening of the movie Night of the Living Dead, starting at 8 p.m.
It looks like Little Shop of Horrors plant, doesn't it?